Hello guys, alright, another video guide farming shadow oils into greater shadow protection, which are going to be very useful in να ξέρω μας πες αλληλόθεμ. So you need to farm two herbs. You need to farm Fadeleaf and GraveMaster. So the best way I found to do this is Scarlet Monastery. So what we do, we enter a library. We're coming here. And then here is little fiddle. Then there is a life root inside here. I usually take it and also kill this boss because I want to waste some time, I don't get blocked. Nothing too crazy. A very simple boss to kill. Can loot him if you want. If you don't want to loot him, it's fine. Pick up the life root. And then next, we are moving into armory. On the way back, you don't have to worry about the mobs, because you are running out of instant. Alright, so we are moving into armory. So here you can charge this and escape it. Then in this area there is a herb spawn, another Fadeleaf. And we are going into Cathedral. And then there is some gold thorn and some life root. Can pick up. Unfortunately, I aggro this mob. I have to kill it. Hmm. All right. And then we are moving into graveyard. In graveyard, that is where you get the grave moss. All right, now we're in the graveyard. And there is Grave Moss and King's Blood. So King's Blood used to make the medium rage pot, if you don't know. This is nice to use them in PvP. Because, you know, my rage pots are very expensive. Compared to the medium rage potions. So we come here, there is another King's Blood. Here we have Grave Moss. All right, this time we go down Leon, unfortunately. We get 1, 2, 3, you know. Depends how lucky you are. And then we're going to move out, and after we enter all the instances, we're going to reset. Right. So, reset, re-enter. We are doing exactly the same thing. Then again, you find King's Blood over here. Usually there's three herb spawns. Sometimes you get two grave moss spawns, like I did now. A bit random. But we will do it 5 times, and then at the end we will see how many herbs we got totally. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, the shadow protection potions are a pain in the ass to make. It's very boring to farm. I know. Very boring to farm. Greater shadow protections. But they're very important, especially in Axe for Lothab. You need at least two each time you fight Lothab. So we need to be prepared. Keep in mind, in Lothab, there's limited amount of heals you can do. It's a tactic. So you need to have shadow protection force if you want to survive the whole fight. So basically, you need to pre-pop one before the fight starts, and then you pop another one during the fight after your first one is run out. You don't need many, though. But a nice guy, he opened the door for me. Wow. Oh, ah. Alright, back to Cathedral. With some more life root and some more gold thorn. Unfortunately, I pulled two mobs. These mobs aggro rates are, no? Okay, we pulled another one. Oh my god, I kicked that. Wow, what a professional. Goldthorn also is very useful for oil formulation. If you want to make some other things, like the cheap NR protection pots. Well, I don't recommend using them. But many mages that they are doing boosts Marauder, they are using them just to make the run smoother. I don't recommend them using them in raids. I don't know, unless you are like casual, very casual. Are way cheaper, like one of these small ones cost less than a gold, and the greater natural protection pots cost around 7G in Gehenna's right at the moment in Hot Side. So yeah, it's up to you. Anyway, okay, now we are back to Armory. Let's see if we can do again the streak. Avoid the so what I'm doing, I'm charging and I'm running away. Another Fadeleaf. Back to library. We're moving this way. There is a patrol. If you aggro him, you're going to most likely aggro all of them. You're boring. Like me, I don't want to kill them right now. So, like I did here, if you want to reset them, you can just stand here. And at some point, they will reset. And if you go behind this candle, you are safe. You won't aggro the other one. Then we are coming here. We are getting the Fadeleaf. Also the life root. Oh, we got the dog whistle. Alright, then we're moving into library and then we will reset. No, we are already in library. What the fuck am I saying? I mean, we're going outside and we reset. We are moving back to library. So I will pause the video now and I will keep doing it until I'm locked out. I will be back to you and I will tell you how many herbs I got. So see you in a moment. Alright, after I did my 5 cutouts, let's see what we got. So we got 1 stack. Fadeleaf. About 1 stack. We got about 1 stack gravy moss. 13 gold thorns. Leave me alone. Mr. Mob, you're interrupting me? Oh, really? Anyway. I can't even enter the instance to be somewhere now, anyway. So. What else? We got 16 life root, 14 king's blood. This was from a chest. I don't count it. And you know, some bad, some random stuff from mobs that I aggro and boss, the first boss in library, which I'm killing. So to make shadow walls, I mean. To make greater shadow protection roll is what you need. Right, let's talk about that. So we are opening Atlas loot. And we are going to protection potions. Then we are going to greater shadow protection potion. So, in order to make one greater shadow protection potions, you need shadow oil, one dream foil, and okay, one vial, crystal vial. So, Shadow Oil. Where are you, Mr. Shadow Oil? There we go. So, Shadow Oil, to make one Shadow Oil, you need 4 Fadeleaf, 4 Grave Moss, and a Battle. So, you need 4 Fadeleaf, 4 Grave Moss, for one. So for each one, you need 4 of these herbs. This one is nasty herb, very, like, it spawns also in the world in some places, like, Eastern EPL in the Darrowshire. Not in Darrowshire, sorry, my mistake. In the Undercroft, there is a spawn of Grimmos. You can find it, for example, in Wentlands. Where else you can find it? You can find it in Dashwood. Dashwood, hello. In Ravenhill, no. Basically, wherever is a graveyard, you can find it. So yeah, that's pretty much. So basically, if you get a little bit more lucky, after you do five lockouts in Scarlet Monastery, you will be able to make at least 3, right? Maybe if you're like, if you're a bit more lucky, you are will be able to make 4. So each Lothab kill requires 2, like we said before. So yeah, you're going to spend about 30 minutes doing maybe even less. I don't know. Depends how fast you are going to do it. I mean, you can also skip a cathedral if you don't want to get some gold thorn and you know, a bit more life root. You can just go do library, armory, and graveyard. In library and in armory, you get Fadeleaf. Usually in armory there's only one spawn, one Fadeleaf spawn. And one is in one spawn you get in armory and one spawn you get in library. And then in graveyard you get from 0 spawns into chance to get 3 spawns of Gravemos. So yeah, you can also skip cathedral if you don't want to farm Goldthorn, but I'm using them. I'm using oil accumulation a lot in the raids, so I would like to farm those two. So yeah, that's it guys, thanks a lot for watching. Probably I will make more videos like this. So yeah, see you next time, bye bye.